First the right, and then the left. And voila.
Oh nein.
What?
Der klopft mir an die Scheiben. Oh Gott.
What the... Oh, for fuck's sake. Can't I work in peace? Jack Handman speaking.
Easy, why so rude?
Steve? Sorry, man. This place is falling apart, and Ridley won't even lift a finger to help. You just can't work here.
Did the centrifuge trip the fuses again?
Yeah, eventually everything's gonna go up in smoke.
Woher weißt du das?
Look on the bright side. It's a free cremation with your autopsy.
Jesus, stop it. That shit pisses me off.
Okay, sorry, Jack. Anyway, I'm calling to ask how the autopsy's going. Soon there'll be journalists sniffing around for info, so we'd best be ready.
I'll whiz through this in a couple of hours. It doesn't look like a complicated case to me. More of a formality. The report will be available in the morning.
Sounds great. Thanks. Phew! How's your head?
Well, my head seems better than yours. On the way to work.
Holy fuck! Jack, turn on the radio!
What? What's happening?
Quiet!
A three-car police convoy was involved in an accident near Pete's Bay Bridge while transporting prisoners to Orleans Parish Prison. At the moment, we do not know the exact number of victims or whether any of the convicts escaped. However, the scale of the accident indicates a large number of victims, possibly even fatal ones. Police are on their way to investigate the incident and secure the area. We know that the injured prisoners are on death row. The police were to transport them to their execution, which was to take place tomorrow morning. Many of them are very dangerous criminals. We will report on the matter on an ongoing basis, so stay tuned with us.
What? Was? Steven. Was Red Pete one of the passengers? He was, wasn't he? What if he survived?
Jack, I have to go. You want me on site?
What if he survived?
I gotta go. Talk to you later, okay?
Fuck. Calm down, Jack. Pills. I need my pills. You heard him, Jack. A serious
Warum
accident.
Ruft ihr Steven an? Er erzählt dem Typ das im Jack jetzt und... Alter, warum? Hol doch einfach und zieh dann nicht. Hol die blöden Pillen.
Yes.
Scheißegal.
Nothing's going to happen. Christ. I've gotta get back to work.
So.
What?
Wow. Das überrascht mich jetzt überhaupt nicht. Habe ich Fenster zu? Okay, Fenster ist zu. So, ciao mit V. Ich gehe jetzt weiter schnibbeln.
Technical break. At least I know I can pursue a career as a janitor if I need to. My own
fucking hell!
Alright, let's see if we were able to get anything out of this piece of crap. And miraculously, yes, the samples did spin. I'll transfer them to the chromograph in the lab.
Schnauze.
All right, Let's load this up. I place the test tubes in the rack. So.
Jetzt nehmen wir Proben. Und wir brauchen
now,
je 5 Milliliter.
From each.
Den Pipette einstellen.
Precisely. And the next.
Und nochmal Pipette einstellen auf 10. Gut. Next. So, und dann nächstes.
5 more.
Und 15. Perfekt. Jetzt ganz runter und loslassen.
We put the prepared sample into the machine.
So, alles klar, es geht automatisch.
Let's see what we have here. The results indicate that the deceased did consume alcohol shortly before her death. However, this is not an amount that could cause poisoning leading to death. Just slight inebriation. I can return to the body and continue the rest of the examination.
Also keinen übermäßigen Alkoholkonsum. Konsumiert zwar schon, aber nicht so, dass extremst.
The chromatograph results show that we can eliminate alcohol poisoning from our list of potential causes of death. However, remember that alcohol can affect the functioning of the entire body. It disturbs the heart rhythm, accelerating its rate, and dilutes the blood, which may result in more severe bleeding in the event of an accident. Also remember that alcohol affects the metabolism of drugs in the liver, which I'll now look at in more detail. First, I'll pick up the syringe again.
Nochmal ne.
I'll take samples from the liver and the heart to test the concentration of barbiturates in the body.
Zwei Proben sogar. Einmal Magen und einmal Herz.
That's enough. I'll do the test later. I'd best not try my luck with the centrifuge right now. Now I remove the liver.
Leber. Leber. Da, Leber. Verpeilterweise. Das scheint alles in Ordnung zu sein.
No lesions. However, it is slightly enlarged. Perhaps it's a slight inflammation or drug-induced damage. It may also be the result of the deposition of substances from drugs. Let's check the weight of the organ.
Okay, ich korrigiere. Es ist nicht okay. Sie ist vergrößert, die Leber. Hä? Auf die Waage.
The weight is 1300 grams. The liver is enlarged. Mm-hmm. I'll move on to a cross-sectional study. Perhaps the enlargement is the result of early cancerous changes. The blade glides through smoothly. I don't feel like I'm encountering any changes with an unusual structure. No steatosis or cirrhosis. The liver is actually quite clean inside.
Das bedeutet, dass die Leber zwar vergrößert war, aber nichts.
The liver is basically healthy. We already know that the deceased didn't abuse alcohol. The question is, what about drugs or other substances? I move on to the heart. glance, we can see signs of a heart attack. The deceased is definitely too young to have a heart attack due to natural causes. The liver is enlarged, not from alcohol poisoning, and the heart looks like it has collapsed. So, I guess we need to go to the centrifuge and check for these barbiturates. The last time I saw this kind of poisoning was a few years ago. I better check the data in my notebook. He was a middle-aged guy. He took his medication and forgot about it. So, he took another pill. He forgot again, and took another one. And another one. Until he took the last one. That's why it's better to have amnesic drugs in boxes labeled with the days of... Alright.
So, Hä? Seite wechseln. Cool. Das, also 10 Minuten und 75%. 10 Minuten 75%. Ah, okay. Wo war denn jetzt meine Maus hin?
We close the centrifuge and pray that it doesn't trip anything again.
Die Maus war kurz weg, das ist ja Katastrophe. Oh, bitte.
It looks like our luck is in.
Die eine Probe sieht ein bisschen komisch aus. Gut.
We can take the samples to the lab now.
Whee! Drehen. Warum auch immer drehen?
I wonder how she
Keine
was
Ahnung.
Able to get hold of these drugs.
Ich glaube, das hat gar keine Bedeutung. Hier im Rack. Los.
Okay. Two samples this time. 6 milliliters each.
Und 6 Milliliter brauche ich da. 6 Milliliter. Gut. Komm schon runter. Und loslassen. Jetzt nochmal hoch. Auf 12. Gut.
Well, let's see how much of it we find.
Was bringt dieses Gerät jetzt an die ans Tageslicht?
Nothing surprising. Significant amounts of phenobarbital metabolites of hepatic origin. Looks like I'll have to check the contents of the deceased's stomach.
Nee, ich will nee. Nee. Muss ich jetzt wirklich noch den Magen aufschneiden? Oh nee. Nee, 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 nee.
The tests show that the collected blood contained enough barbiturates to cause cardiopulmonary collapse. The question now is whether it was an accident or a deliberate act. I'm proceeding to examine the stomach. Before extraction, I ligate the entire organ to prevent its contents from spilling out. Okay, I'm now cutting out the organ, which will move to the board for dissection. Normally, the stomach and intestines are full of surprises.
Huch. Nein. Oh, ich darf nicht an den Rand kommen. Heißer Draht. Action-Scheiß-Dreck. Entschuldigung. Nicht an den Rand.
But not this time. Okay, we see remnants of undigested food and a dense mass of pills. Mm. You don't take this many drugs by accident.
Oh, no.
Length and width normal. No obvious pathological changes. Undigested drugs found in the stomach of the deceased. The direct cause of death was probably an overdose. I'll check the rest of the organs,
die Lunge,
and then the nervous system. We'll see how significant the marks on the neck are for the whole case.
Die schwarzen Lungen.
Lungs are normal, no lesions. The victim was probably a smoker, but was unlike the deceased's trachea as normal. Complete patency. No food or fluid.
Hä? Ach, okay, jetzt, ja.
The deceased's intestine is normal.
Gut.
No clear pathological changes. Abdominal cavity checked off. We can check the brain.
Jetzt wird's wieder lecker. Ach, Scheibengläser, warten Sie mal, warten Sie mal.
I make a cut to open the lid of the victim's skull and remove the brain. Normal. No obvious lesions. All right. I need to dissect it on a board.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, das Gehirn schneiden.
Using a knife, I carefully cut through the brain tissue. I peek inside a bit, and...
Sehr witzig.
I don't think there's anything worth noting.
Komm schon, was bringt das
As expected,
jetzt hervor?
The deceased's brain is in excellent condition. No discoloration
Nix.
Or changes due to hypoxia. There is still the matter of the marks on the neck. They look superficial, but who knows? Maybe the spinal cord has been severed. I need goggles and a saber saw. I think the goggles were in the desk drawer. Oh, they're out there. Saw. I need saw. Fuck. I don't see it here. Oh. I know. I probably left it in the basement after its last cleaning.
Wo ist denn der Keller? Da ist Labor. Toilette, Büro. Lagerraum, Frühstücksraum. Oder Aufenthaltsraum.
Mr. Ridley, I need a key to the basement.
It's in the social room.
Why is the key lying at the... never mind. Thank you.
Hey, Hammond. Did you hear about the convoy? Well, maybe you'll get a chance to relive your glory days and catch Red Beat again, huh?
Let's hope there won't be any
Alter,
for that.
Halt doch deinen Mund, Mr. Ridley!
If only he could put that much enthusiasm into it. I get the feeling that searching through this rubbish is more pathogenic than working with corpses.
Yeah, okay.
Please, may this be the last trip.
Wo zum Henker ist der Keller?
Fuck! Why did the prison convoy have to get into an accident? Jack, take a deep breath. Deep. Pleasantly cool breath. You're nearly finished with the autopsy. Then you can go home and rest.
Mm. Okay, hier ist der Keller wahrscheinlich.
I'll take the saw.
Hopp. Oh nein. Alter.
Fuck! It's jammed! Doesn't anyone do maintenance around here? Damn hatch. Damn red peat. Never again. If only.
Was ist das? Was ist das? Hä? Wohnt hier irgendwer oder haust hier irgendwer? Oh Mann, ey. Wo ist meine Säge? Tralala. Okay.
It would be easier if I put things away properly.
Ich muss hier raus.
Ugh, damn student lectures and their fucking props. And like clockwork, he's already sleeping.
So, okay. Oh Gott. Ich befürchte, das wird jetzt übel.
Sorry for the short interruption. I hope you all took the opportunity to grab some coffee. And now that I have everything I need, I'll move on to revealing the spinal cord.
Ach du Scheiße. Oh Gott. Oh mein Gott.
The spine is I can see that the spinal cord was not severed. This shows that apart from the marks around the neck, hanging didn't negatively affect the condition of the deceased. Ladies and gentlemen, almost over. Now, to sum up and tidy away the body. The direct cause of Samantha Barker's death was a heart attack resulting from an overdose of barbiturates. Traces found on the body suggest that the overdose was a deliberate act, following a failed attempt to hang herself. The autopsy found no evidence or genetic materials indicating that death could have been the result of an attack. Third party involvement must be excluded.
Das da.
Autograph, and we can start sewing.
Und nochmal unterschreiben mit. Huch.
In the 1950s and 1960s, the use of barbiturates for suicide was actually quite common. I think it was most talked about after the death of Marilyn Monroe.
Okay. Alter.
At home, it was a help and comfort.
Zunehmen.
On death row, a farewell to the convicts. Well, we're done for today. Thank you for your attention.
So, jetzt muss ich die weglegen, ne? In das Kühlding da.
Tiring day. I can feel those hunger pains coming on. I guess I'll have to pick something up along the way. Gloves in the trash, leave the apron for cleaning. Now I can go.
Hilfe!
Camera.
Gottes Himmel, Trill.
A nightcap will do me good.
Nein, kein Schlummertrunk. Du holst Pillen, alter Falter.
Good night, Mr. Ridley. The police will pick up the body and accompanying documentation in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure. Stinkefinger.
I guess there are actually two things in this world you can be certain of. Death and Ridley's reluctant attitude.
Huch. Regnet das? Oder was ist das? Ich will nach Hause. Los.
Alright. Maybe three things. Find whiskey on the rocks when I get home.
Nein.